Hello, welcome to Arvind Academy. We are discussing matrix and determinants, and today we are going to discuss about the matrices. This is video lecture number 5. I hope you have already watched part 1 or part 4 before watching this part 5. So in this lecture, I am going to discuss about some more properties of matrices, that is minors and cofactors. So let us discuss minors and cofactors. Minors and cofactors. So what is minors? Minors. So minor age. Basically, before discussing this minor, I would like to discuss just introductory knowledge about the determinant. So let me first discuss about the determinant. What is determinant? Determinant is the arrangement similar like matrices like A, B, C, D. If it put in two vertical bars, between two vertical bars, then this is called determinant of order. Determinant of order 2, order 2. 2 means 2 into 2. So determinant is always in form of a square. And what is the difference between the matrix and determinant? That determinant is always put between two vertical bars. Some other characteristics are also differ by the matrices, but we will discuss it later on when we will discuss properly determinant. Till now, I can say determinant of this is called determinant of order 2, and the value that can be obtained as multiply by this minus this. So AD minus BC is the value of this determinant, and that is for our purpose. Similarly, determinant of order 3 can be also evaluated. You have learned in class 11th about the how to evaluate the determinant of order 3. For example, if I have 2, 3, 5, 1, 4, 6 and 2, 0, minus 1 like this, then you can solve it by using this 2 times of, you can expand along any row or any column. So 2 into this cancel, this cancel. So what is value left? Value left is like this. These are the subdeterminant. If I remove the row and column in which they lie, then it will be 4, 6, 0 and minus 1. Then put negative sign, and what 3 will be there. So we can put 3 times of this cancel and this cancel. So what is left? 1, 2 and 6 minus 1. This is called subdeterminant. This is determinant of order 3 and that is determinant of order 2. So it is described as subdeterminant. And now 5 times of 5 into, if 5 belong to first row and third column, so first row and third column can be removed. And now what is left? 1, 2, 4, 0. And value can be obtained. So first of all, we have to, since we are expanding along R1 means row first row along, expanding along first row, for 2 times of this cancel in which 2 belongs first row, so first row to be eliminated and first column to be eliminated, then what is left? These 4 are left only. 4, 6, 0, minus 1, 4, 6, 0, minus 1. Similarly, if I took the second one to be taken as negative, why I will take it negative? I will discuss it later on, but till now, you must remember that this will be negative. And negative times of 3. Then if it lie 3 here, then this row and this column should be cancels out. And you can find it 1, 2, 6, minus 1. And then 5 to be taken, and 5 belong in third row and first column, so we will have to eliminate third row and first column as well, and we will have to calculate this 5 times of 1, 2, 4, 0. Now if you calculate this 2 times of, similarly like this, 4 into minus 1 is minus 4 and 0 into 6 is 0, so like this, 3 into this is minus 1 and minus 12, and that is 5 times of 0 minus 8. So finally, the answer of this will come like 2 times of minus 4 is minus 8, and this is minus 13 into minus 3 is plus 39, and 5 into 8 is minus 40. So minus 48 and minus 48 plus 39 is minus 9, and this is the answer of this question. So third order determinant can be also evaluated, but this is not things which we need to discuss right now. I have to just discuss that sub-determinant of order 2, how can you solve. There is another idea in which this can be also solved called Cyrus rule. Let me discuss this. 2, 3 and 5, 1, 4 and 6, and 2, 0 and minus 1. We need to write first two row again. Right now, we need to write this one. We need to write first two row again, right? And first two row again, 2, 1, and 2, and this is 3, 4, and 0. And now, using Cyrus rule. Cyrus rule is what? Cyrus rule. On the basis of this, how we can evaluate determinant. Cyrus rule. So, on the basis of this, we have to calculate this, like take product of rows, this diagonal elements, product of diagonal element, this one, then product of this diagonal element. According to this rule, we have to find the product of 2 into 4, that is 8. 8 into minus 1 is minus 8. Minus 8, I can write here. The value can be obtained as minus 8. And product of these two is 6, 3 ja 18. 18 into 2 is 36. And this one is 5 into 1 into 0, that is 0, minus product of these two. So 5 into 4, 5 4 is 20 into 2, 40, 40 plus product of 0 into 6 into 2 is 0, and product of minus 1 into 1 minus 1 multiply with 3 is minus 3. So value can be obtained like this. So 36 minus, and the answer is minus 9. So same answer can be obtained. This is called Cyrus rule. You can calculate the determinant of order 3 in this way also. But what we wanted to learn in terms of matrices, the term is minor. And what is minor? So minor of an element of the matrix or determinant, minor of an element, minors. So definition is minor of an element Aij of determinant is the value of sub-determinant which is obtained by eliminating ith row and jth column, right? It is denoted by Mij. So let us consider a determinant of order 2 into 2. So in that case, what will happen? Say we have a matrix A is a determinant in which 3, 5, 2, 6, and we have to find minor of A11. So A11, minor of A11, that is element belong to first row and first column, age, nothing else but M11, and that can be obtained by eliminating the first row and first column. So what is left? That is 6. Similarly, minor of A12, age M12, which is obtained by eliminating first row and second column. So first row and second column, if I eliminate, then what is left? If I eliminate this first row and first second column, then 2 will be left. So minor of this is only 2. Now minor of A21, each second row and first column, if I eliminate, that will be 5 left. And minor of A22, is the value of subdeterminant, that is eliminating second row and second column. So what is left? That is 3 left. So that is 3. So minor of second order determinant can be obtained like this. Now if determinant of order 3 is there, then how can you find the minor? Suppose P is a determinant and here 3, 5, 2, minus 1, 0, 6, 1 and 2 and 0. And we have to find minor of all these elements I want to write. So minor of first row M11, that is first row and first column, is obtained by eliminating first row and first column. So what is left? 2, 0, 2 and 6, 0. That is 0 minus 12. And what is that? Minus 12. Similarly, M12 is the minor of first row and second column. If I eliminate the first row and second column, then subdeterminant which is left out is minus 1, first row and second column. So minus 1, 1 and 6, 0. So in that case, if I calculate like this, multiplication of these two is 0 and multiplication of these two is minus 6. So minus 6. M13 is what? M13, first row and third column. So left, what is left? That is minus 1 and 1 and 0 and 2. So that will be minus 2. Product of these two is minus 2. First you have to find product like this and then minus this. So minus 2 and minus 0. So what is left? Minus 2. Similarly, if I would write here the minor of M21. Similarly, so we can obtain directly, I would like to write directly minor of M21. So M21 can be obtained by using M21. That is what I want to write it. M21, this cancel, so 0 and 5 left, so 0 into 5 is 0 and 2 into 2 is 4, so 0 minus 4 is minus 4. Similarly, M22 is what? M22, that is second row and second column, so this multiply by this, 0 multiply by 3 is 0, minus 2 multiply by 1, that is minus 2, so minus 2. M23 can be written as eliminating second row, that is this one, and second column, third column. So what is left? 3 to the 6 minus 5. 6 minus 5 is 1. Similarly, we can obtain minors of third row as well. That is M31, that is third row and first column. So in that case, 6, 5 is 30 minus 0, that is 30. M32, and what is that? Third row and second column. If I eliminate this third row and second column, then what is left? This 4 are left. 6, 3 is 18 minus minus 2. 18 minus minus 2 is 20. Right now? And now M33. M33 is third row and third column. So 0 multiplied by 3 is these 4 are left. Only these 4 are left in that case. So 0 multiply by 3 is 0 minus 1 multiply by minus 5, that is minus 5, but negative of minus 5 is plus 5. So answer is 5. So in that way, you can calculate the minor of any element in a determinant, and minor of any element in a determinant can be obtained by what the definition is. Definition is that minor of an element is a deter of an element in a determinant is the value of subdeterminant, which is obtained by eliminating ith row and jth column. That is, the element in which row and column belongs, we need to eliminate those row and column, and thereafter what is left, that we have to calculate the value of determinant can be calculated. So now it's time to know about the cofactors. So what is cofactor? Let me explain cofactor is, what is cofactor? So cofactor is nothing else but cofactor of an element aij of a determinant is defined as Cij, that is minus 1 to the power I plus j Mij. So in minor of ij, minor of an element multiply by minus 1 to the power I plus j, and that will be cofactor. So let us consider once again the example of 2 into 2, and in 2 into 2, say, let us consider a matrix P, determinant P, and 3, 5, 0, and 6, if I have to write, let me write this 2. So in that case, C factor, cofactor of C11 is minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1, because I is 1, J is 1, and minor of M11 is first row and first column. After eliminating first row and first column, what is the value left? 6. So that is 6. Minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 to even. So minus 1 to the power even is plus 1 multiplied by 6. That is 6. So minor and cofactor has no difference. Even minor of C11 and cofactor of C11 has the same value. C12. If I write C12, then this will be minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2. And that can be obtained by eliminating first row and second column. So that is 2. So 2 will come. And therefore, minus 1 to the power 3, that is an odd number. So negative of 2. And C21 is what? C21 is also minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1. I can write 2 plus 1 and 1 plus 2 is the same thing. So I can write here 2 plus 1. And second row and first column, if I eliminate, then 5 is left. So that will be minus 5. And C22, that is eliminating second row and second column. So again, minus 1 to the power 2 plus 2. And this is 3 left. So what is that? 3. So these two, minor of these two will change by negative sign. Minor of these two will change by negative sign. And remaining, where there is a sum of these two, I plus j is an odd number, then there will be change by negative sign. Otherwise, minor and cofactor will be same. Got it? Similarly, if I have to calculate minor of matrix of order 3, then what will happen? Say, determinant is P is equal to 5, 2, 1, 3, 0, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 4, like this. And I want to write minor of cofactor of C11. So minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1. And now directly I can calculate this cancel, this cancel. So 0 minus 2, that is minus 2. So 0 minus 2 is minus 2. And because minus 1 to the power 2 is an even, so it will be minus 2. So minor and cofactor will be same. But C12 is first row and second column. In this case, minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2, that is 3. So it will be a negative sign. And this cancel, this cancels. So what is that? 4, 3 is 12 minus minus 2. That is 12 plus 2, which is 14. So that will be minus 14. C13. C13 is what? Eliminating first row and third column. So that will be again minus 1 to the power 1 plus 3. And first row and third column after eliminating this, this is minus 6 minus 0. So it will be minus 6. So finally answer is minus 6. So out of these three, only this will change with negative sign. Rest of them has the same minor as well as cofactor. Similarly, this is C21. 2 plus 1 is an odd. This is C23. That will be 2 plus 3 is a 5, which is odd. And here this 3, C32. 3 plus 2 is 5. That is also an odd number. So these four will change by negative sign in terms of minor and cofactors. Rest of them will not change. They will have minor, same value as minor as well as cofactors. So C21, I can write here, this cancel, this cancel. And what is left? These four will change with negative sign. So C21, second row and first column. If I cancel this, eliminate this, then what is left? 4 to 8 minus minus 2, that is 8 plus 2 is 10. So minus 1 to the power 2 plus 1 and 10, that is minus 10. C22, and what is that? This cancel, this cancel. Here again, minus 1 to the power 2 plus 2, so it will be 4. So sign will not change because it will be positive. This cancel and this cancel. 5, 4, 20 minus 2. 20 minus 2 is 18. So answer is 18. And C23 is nothing else but minus 1 to the power 2 plus 3. That is 5. So again, this will be an odd number and that is why sign will change. And now this cancel and this cancel. So 5, 2, 5 into minus 2 is minus 10. And minus 4, minus 14, and because it will change with sign, so it will be finally 14. Similarly, now C31 can be calculated like this cancel and this cancel. So what is left? 2 multiply by minus 1, that is minus 2, minus 1 to the power 3 plus 1, and minus 2, minus 0. So this will be positive. This term will be positive itself, but due to this minus 2, it will remain minus 2. C32 is this cancel and this cancel. These four cancels. So 5 multiply by minus 1, that is minus 5. First, I need to write here minus 1 to the power 3 plus 2, and third row and second column. If I eliminate, this will be minus 5, minus 3, minus 8. And due to this, it will be plus 8. Sign will change. And C33, that will be again, this cancel, this cancel. And here, minus 1 to the power 3 plus 3, that is 6. So sign will not change. And now, this cancel, this cancel. 0 multiply by 5 is 0, minus 6, that is minus 6. And because it is positive value, so minus 6. So cofactor can be calculated like this. Directly you can calculate without writing the value of subdeterminant. Otherwise, you can write a step by step that break it like minus 1. C11 can be written as like you can do also like that. C11 is minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1. Now, first row and first column eliminated, and then what is the value of subdeterminant? That is 0, minus 2, minus 1, and 4. Like this can be calculated as well. But here it will be plus, and this will be 0, minus 2. And what is that? Minus 2. So, finally, the answer is minus 2. So, you can do it a step by step like this if you are a learner. But if you have learned it, and after some practice, you can write it directly. Now, why the question is why we have learned this? Why? What is the use of this? What is the use of this cofactor? So there are some characteristics that cofactor characteristics of this. There are some characteristics that cofactor if properties of cofactors. First, if element of any row is multiplied by corresponding cofactors, then their sum is equal to value of determinant, right? For example, if I can write here A11 and C11, A12, C12, A13, C13, that will be equal to value of determinant. This represents the value of determinant, whatever the value will come. Here, you can calculate it and use it, also verify it. The element of first row is 5. 5. So, 5 multiply by cofactor minus 2 plus first row 2 multiply by minus 14, 2 multiply by minus 14 plus the 1 multiply by minus 6, 1 multiply by minus 6, and that will be equal to minus 10, minus 28 and minus 6. So minus 38 and minus 6 is equal to minus 44. That will be the value of this determinant. You can check it. Minus 44 is the value of determinant. Similarly, if we select any other row, suppose A121 and C21, A22, C22, A23, C23, that will be also the value of determinant. And if I took A31, C31, A32, C32, AC33, C33, then that will be also the value of determinant, etc. So, not only row, but also the column of determinant will give the same value. So, let me write another property. The value of the element of any column multiplied by corresponding cofactors, then their sum is equal to value of determinant, right? So not only row but columns can be column wise can be also obtained. And C11 plus C11 A11 element of first row and first column and C11 A21 C21 A31 C31, then that will be also the value of determinant. And A first row second column, and this is first row second column, and this will be second row second column C22 A second row, third row, second column, right? And third row, second column, then that also value will be the determinant. And in similar way, etc., we can say. Now, the third characteristic is, if elements of any row is multiplied by corresponding cofactors of other row, then their sum is equal to zero. Right? Like suppose I have taken the first row, element of first row A11 and A21, cofactors of second A12 and C22, A13 and C23. That is elements of first row I have taken and cofactors of second row I have taken, then the value will be zero. Similarly, if I take element of second row A21 and cofactor of third row A22, C32, A23, C33, then value will be zero. So if elements of any row and cofactors, corresponding cofactors of any other row, then value will be zero. Similarly, fourth property is there. And what is that fourth property? Fourth property is, if elements of any column, is multiplied by corresponding cofactors of any other column, then their sum is equal to zero. Right? This one. So say CA11, first column, and cofactors of second column, A12, A21, and C22, A31 and C32, right now. So here I have taken the elements of first column and cofactors of second column, then their value will be zero. Similarly, if I took elements of second column A12 and C13, A22 and this is C23, right? A32 and this is C33, then also the value will be zero. So these are few characteristics of the value of determinant which can be obtained. You can verify any one of them. For example, if I have taken, say, first 5, 3, 2 is the elements of first column. Say, let me verify this. 5, 3, 2 is the element of first column. 5, 3, 2 is the element of first column and multiply by cofactors of second column. So what are the cofactors of second column? So cofactor of second column is 14, minus 14, 18 and 8, right? Minus 14, 18 and 8. So minus 14, 18 and 8. -14, 18 and 8, right? So what is that? Using the same characteristics I have taken here, just for verification. So what will come? See, 14 5 jar minus 70, 18 3 jar 54 and 8 2 jar 16. So this is minus 70 plus 70, which is equal to 0. So that is a verification, you know. So you can check it your own, and definitely it will come like this property will satisfy. So this is the fact and final property. You can use it anywhere, whether it is in terms of row or in terms of column, it will satisfy. So these are few properties of cofactors and minors. And also column wise, you can check it, the value of determinant, the first column is. So also value of determinant can be obtained just for verification that what is the value, because we have calculated answer is minus 44 here, and we need to verify this. 5, 3, 2, 2, 0, minus 2 and 1, minus 4. 5, 3, 2, 2, 5, 3, 2 and this is 1, 0, minus 1. Sorry. 3, 2, 2, 0, minus 2, 1, minus 1, 4. So we have to calculate this. Let me check out whether the value of determinant will be same or not. So either you can use it Cyrus rule, or you can do it like this. 5 into this cancel, 0 minus minus 2. So minus 2 will be there, because 0 minus 2. And now second, I can take minus 2, or even minus 2, or even minus 3. Let me expand this time column wise, because earlier we did row wise. So now I am taking first along first column. So this cancel, this cancel. Now 4 2 jar 8 minus minus 2. So 8 plus 2 is 10. Now plus 2 times 2 into a, this cancel and this cancel. So minus 2 minus 0. Minus 2 minus 0. So finally it will be minus 10, and 10 3 jar 30, minus 30 and minus 4. So what is that? Minus 44. So that is a verification that what we have said and what we have observed, that is absolutely correct. Delta means the value of determinant. So wherever there is a delta sign, it means the value of determinant we will use in terms of matrix and determinant. So hopefully you got it, the what is the factors and what are their characteristics, and how you can use it. Okay, so now last break we will discuss the adjoint and inverse of. Take care.